Hariyom, namaste to all the viewers. I welcome you all on this national webinar series, Yoga Ramayana Vishwakosha History. Continuing yesterday's topic, we have Dr. Manjunath Gururaj sir speaking about the conversation between Bharata and Lord Rama and how Lord Rama counsels Bharata to take up the throne until he moves back to the kingdom.
Namaste, all of you. श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम ओम सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ओम शांति शांति शांतिः। कूजन्तं राम रामेति मधुरं मधुराक्षरम् आरुह्य कविता शाखां वंदे वाल्मीकि कोकिलम् मानिषाध प्रतिष्ठां त्वं अगमः शाश्वती समाः यत्क्रौञ्च मिथुनादेकं अवधीः काममोहितम्। श्री राम राम रामेति रमे रामे मनोरमे सहस्रनाम तत्तुल्यं रामनाम वरानने। डियर व्यूअर्स, टुडे इन कंटिन्यूएशन विद द कॉन्वर्सेशंस ऑफ रामा एंड भरता, सो what were the advices given and how Rama convinced Bharata to go back and rule the kingdom for 14 years till he comes. That we were discussing, and yatha kashtancha kashtancha sameyata maharaname evam darascha putrascha gnatavyascha dhananicha. So this is how Rama advises Bharata. Like two wooden logs meet together in the flow of the rivers. You know, one wooden log will come from one side and another wooden log will be coming from other side. Yatha kashtancha kashtancha sameyatam maharaname. In the flow of this river spade. So they come together and they join together. They go together for a while, for some time, and they get separated. So this is the status of our life activities also. Even our people whom we meet together in life, they come and they meet us and they will be with us for a while, and after the job is over they go yuyam yuyam vayam vayam. So with this type of attitude, the whole life is a surprise and we have to accept it as it comes. So this is what the beauty of the knowledge given by Rama to Bharata. So Bharata is totally getting convinced by Rama's words, the philosophical wordings of Rama, which is going to make Bharata a completely satisfied person. Though he comes along with all the people gathered by the Ayodhya to take back Rama and Sita, Lakshmana, everyone. So he was very much confident that he will take back Rama. But the Rama's wordings, Rama's philosophy of life, the way how he started counseling Bharata, that made him to accept without any questioning him. And finally, this is how he's philosophically, he's trying to convince Bharata that yatha kashtancha kashtancha sameyatam maharaname evam darascha putrascha, even the wife, even the children, evam darascha putrascha gnatavyascha, known people also, people of wisdom, they come and they are going to just after their work done. So as much as when they are necessary, that much only That's why runanubandha rupeena pashupatni sutalaya, that wording which is going to help us to understand this shloka from Ramayana, where Valmiki describes this in a fantastic way with all the wordings. The Valmiki's explanation of Ramayana totally it is spread in Anushtup Chandas only. So where Anushtup Chandas is the most beautiful Chandas, for which the shlokas are going to be very, very fascinating for even by hearting and as well as in interpretation, and even in all ways of our life we have to accept these changes. Yatha dharascha putrascha jnatavyascha and dhananicha, even the money comes and money goes. This is how Rama is trying to convince Bharata. So Bharata still, he is not ready to accept it, and he says that no, with all the things, because I am the son of my mother Kaikeyi and I hate her for taking this decision to send you for 14 years of this Aranyavasa, so that I don't agree with. Then Rama finally he says this statement that vanat pratyagato hyam, vanat pratyagato hi aham. So after finishing my 14 years of this exile, vanat pratyagato hi aham bhratra saha bhavishyami prithivi patiruttamaha. Bhratra saha, yes, don't worry Bharata, you do, I'll be there with you mentally, definitely. Physically if I am not there, then no problem, but mentally I am always there with you. After this 14 years, vanat pratyagato hi aham bhratra saha bhavishyami prithivi patiruttamaha. Prithivipati, yes, together I am going to do the administration of this Ayodhya Rajya. So this is how you should get back along with the people with whom you have come. And Kamadva, so one wonderful way the Rama's statement with Bharata, which goes like this: Kamadva tata lobhadva tubhyam idam kritam natan manasikartavyam vartitavyam cha matruvat. See, whatever I may be harsh in telling you, but this is not out of any rage or any angriness. Vartitavyam cha matruvat. So even out of that compassion towards you and towards the Ayodhya Vasis, kamadva tata lobhadva, no, not with any greed, tata lobhadva, kama and lobha, desire and greed, kamadva tata lobhadva tubhyam idam kritam. So you have not done anything with lalchiness or that greediness, you have not done that. Tubhyam idam kritam natan manasi kartavyam. So you are not doing it with any bad intention. Natan manasi kartavyam vartitavyam cha matruvat. Like the mother takes care, the overall taking care of the child is by his mother. How the mother is going to take care? In that way, please take care of the Ayodhyavasis. Vartitavyam cha matruvat. So develop that attitude of motherhood. When you are going to rule this Ayodhya for 14 years, I will come back. Definitely, vanat pratyagata aham, vanat pratyagato hi aham, bratra saha, definitely, bhavishyami, prithivipati matmanaha, prithivipati ruttamaha. Prithivipati, I am going to, definitely, after 14 years, I am going to rule along with you. So till then, you take care of the Ayodhyavasis. You take care of the people of Ayodhya, like vartitavyancha matruvat. See, this is the most important message given by Rama to Bharata. Bharata is completely, he was in disarray when he got the message that Rama was sent to exile by his own mother. Then the way how he is going to behave, the way how he behaved with his mother, that is something, you know, sorry, not acceptable. But still, you know, he uses many harsh words towards his mother Kaikeyi. You go to hell. So all these words are being spoken by Bharata with Kaikeyi. But when he comes back with the confidence that I will bring back Rama, Lakshmana, Sita, everyone, so then he was totally reconciled by Rama that he cannot take his decision back, and definitely you go along with everyone and take care of the Ayodhyavasis like mother takes care of her child, like a mother takes care of her child in all directions, in all vibhaga. The mother, yes, in the same way, you should also be in the status of mother. So, vartitavyancha matruvat, that matrutva bhavana, you must have it. That matrutva bhavana is a must for any king. He should be like a mother. So, vartitavyancha matruvat. So, develop this attitude of matrutva bhava while ruling the kingdom in my absence. Don't worry, I'll be back. Vanat pratyagata hi aham bhratrevena saha prithivipate prithivim. So, that's why I will just rule the Ayodhya definitely along with you. So, please go now. So, these are some of the beautiful wordings of Valmiki, which convinces him. Adhirohaya padabhyam. Then what he says? Adhirohaya. Then Bharata, he is not ready. But still, you know, he gets convinced and says, requests Rama to give his paduka. At least I cannot sit on the throne, but your paduka will be there on the seat. But I will be ruling. No problem. But I cannot sit on that place where it is reserved for you. But your paduka will be there. So representing, you are going to represent the paduka there. So we think that it is, you are there in the form of paduka there. Adhirohaya padabhyam. Bharata is going to request. So again, so while the conversation is happening between Rama and Bharata, and Rama almost convinces Bharata to go back. But on one condition, Bharata says, I will go back, but with this request, one request, please definitely consider my request, O brother Rama. What is that? It is wonderfully told by Valmiki. Adhirohaya padabhyam paduke hemabhushite etai sarvalokasya yogakshemam vidhasyataha. Yogakshemam vidhasyataha. We all feel that security only when your paduka is there. So don't say no to this. Adhirohaya padabhyam. So your paduka, with folded hands I am requesting, O Rama, O brother, so please give your paduka so that adhirohaya, I am going to put it, or I am going to make it as the throne, and that paduka will be there on the seat. Because I have no eligibility to sit on that. Even after you giving the consent to rule the Ayodhya, but I am not there. I am not there to sit on the throne. Adhirohaya padabhyam paduke hemabhushite. Paduke hemabhushite. So what he did? That paduka, what he took? He just completely covered that with hemabhushite. That means with gold covering, gold plated. Paduka. He made that wooden paduka which was worn by Rama, that was taken by Bharata. Paduke hemabhushite. So where he just made it into a wonderful gold plate covering. And adhirohaya padabhyam paduke hemabhushite etaihi sarvalokasya. So with all this blessings from Lord Rama, sarvalokasya yogakshemam vidhasyataha. Etaihi sarvalokasya. So, with all the blessings from Lord Rama, Bharata is just taking that hema paduka. Adhirohaya padabhyam paduke hema bhushite. That paduka which is completely smeared with hema. Hema means gold. Hema bhushite. Then, etaihi sarvalokasya. With all the blessings of Lord Rama, Bharata took that paduka. That is completely covered with, he made it later. He just took the paduka. It was the wooden paduka. But later on, he just made it into completely covered by the gold plated. And that was kept on the throne. That was kept on the seat of that palace where Raja must sit. So it was not the Bharata who sat on the chair, throne. It was the paduka which decorated the chair. Etaihi sarva lokasya. So with all the blessings of Rama and as well as with others, people cooperation, yogakshemam vidhasyataha. Yogakshemam vidhasyataha. Just this is the Bharata who is requesting. So I can take care of the Ayodhyavasis and other like, because Vartitavyan cha Matruvat, he said no. So just behave like a Matrutva Bhava. So that Matrutva Bhava, if I have to develop, then Yogakshemam Vidhasyataha, I get all the blessings only through you. So please allow me to take your paduka. This is what Bharata's request. Then there is a beautiful way how he, that Rama, is advising once again. Because Bharata's fury is so much that nobody could control Bharata. Nobody could control Bharata. Because he was totally against to his own mother only. With all these things happening there. So he wanted to chastise her, send her. He never considered her as mother only. So with these wordings and all, you know, very harsh wordings, Valmiki is going to portray this Bharata's character there. Very angry, young angry man. So young angry man with all his, you know, that fury. So Rama knew very well. Rama was definitely knowing that Bharata is going to get convinced only by my words. So that's why Rama says here, Kaikeyim Mataram Raksha Marosham Kurutan Prati. Kaikeyim Mataram Raksha. See, when he was about to kill. See, the way how he chastises Kaiki is that, go and take Visha, take poison or hang yourself. All these words are being used by Bharata against Kaiki for sending Rama to exile for 14 years. So Rajjum, he says, Rajjum means get yourself hanged, okay, or take the poison and die. So I don't want to see you here. So with all that Rosha, Rama came to know all these behaviors of Bharata. So that's why, Kaikeyim Mataram Raksha Marosham Kurutan Prati. Marosham, never ever you should show your angriness. Please don't show the angriness towards your mother. Kaikeyim Mataram Raksha Marosham Kurutan Prati. Rosha, don't show your Rosha towards mother. She is always a mother. Mother is always a mother. So you cannot behave like the way how you behaved. Okay? Mayacha Sitaya Chaiva Shapathosi Ragusattama. He says, Mayacha Sitaya Chaiva. Mayacha Sitaya Chaiva Shapathosi Ragusattama. Hey Ragusattama. That means he is addressing. Rama is addressing Bharata there as Raghusattama. Now you are the one who has to take care of everyone. So please, Kaikeyim Mataram Raksha. Marosham Kurutan Prati. Never ever show you are angry. So give me a word. Give me the oath. Give me Shapatha. It is not only my Shapatha. It is Mayacha Sitaya Chaiva. We both are asking you that promise. We both are asking you that promise that you are not going to show your angriness. You are not going to show your angriness towards Kaiki. So, Kaikeyim Mataram Raksha Marosham Kurutan Prati Mayacha Sitaya Chaiva Shapathosi Raghusattama Mayacha Sitaya Chaiva. Together we both are going to ask you this word. Together we are going to ask this word. We want that promise from you. Hey Bharata, you have to give us the first of the promise. So only that promise will make us console, and we can definitely rely on you. For that reason only, we are asking this promise from you. Not only me, along with Maya cha Sitaya chaiva. Maya cha Sitaya chaiva shapathosi raghusattama. Shapatha. So please give me that promise, give me that oath that you are not going to marosham kurutan prati kaikeyim mataram raksha. So protect her with all your duties. It is your duty to protect her. So this is how Rama tries to convince, because Rama's character itself is like that, you know. One who is in an angry man, you know, utsaveshu cha sarveshu piteva parityushyati. So this is how Rama is. Rama's character is always like that, you know. Anybody who is coming with angriness, you know, he never used to speak with them. He used to say, no problem, you are in angry mood now, let us talk later. So this is the way the character of Rama, how he used to behave with the public and as well as other people. Vyasaneshu manushyanam brusham bhavati dukkitaha utsaveshu cha sarveshu piteva parityushyati. This is the character, how Rama character is being portrayed by Valmiki. Yeah, this is very much clear now when Rama is conversing with Bharata here, is it not? So this is how vyasaneshu manushyanam, when a person is completely depressed or sad, he himself, Rama himself, used to feel that sadness as if it has happened in his life. Vyasaneshu manushyanam brusham bhavati dukkitaha utsaveshu cha sarveshu. So when the other people are going to be very happy and come and share that happiness with Rama, so even Rama used to feel that happiness. Utsaveshu cha sarveshu, like a father, how he is going to become very happy by seeing the prosperity of the child. In the same way, like a father, how he is going to become very, very happy seeing the progress of the child, the same type of happiness Rama also used to feel it. So that's why Bharata, when he came with the angriness, that furiness, you know, he tried to console him completely. Okay, he tried to console him completely and re-counsel him in such a way that he will go back along with that. So he went back along with Paduka. Paduka hemabhushite, paduke hemabhushite, with that he left again back. So this is how the way of counseling techniques, we can take it for a wonderful counseling technique of Rama towards Bharata in this way, in few shlokas. There are many shlokas which are going to be there in Ramayana, the way how we can understand how Rama's counseling techniques towards Bharata. Thank you very much. Hari Om Tat Sat.
Thank you very much, Dr. Manjunath Gururaj sir, for beautiful depiction on the conversation between Bharata and Lord Rama. We'll come again with another topic tomorrow. Namaste.